Floating nuclear power stations are vessels that are self-contained, low-capacity, floating nuclear power plants. The stations are to be mass-produced at shipbuilding facilities and then towed to the destination ports of the cities and towns experiencing deficit of power due to industrialization. The work on such projects dates back to MH1A, which was built in the 1960s into the hull of a World War II Liberty ship. However, the Rosatom project is the first mass-produced floating nuclear power plant. The floating nuclear power station is a non-self-propelled vessel. It has length of 144.4 meters, 474 feet, width of 30 meters, 98 feet, height of 10 meters, 33 feet, and draft of 5.6 meters, 18 feet. The vessel has a displacement of 21,500 tons and a crew of 69 people. Each vessel of this type has two modified KLT-40 naval propulsion reactors together providing up to 70 megawatt of electricity or 300 megawatt of heat, or generation of electricity and heat for district heating, enough for a city with a population of 200,000 people. It could also be modified as a desalination plant producing 240,000 cubic meters of fresh water a day. Smaller modification of the plant will be fitted with two ABV-6M reactors with the electrical power around 18 megawatts of electricity. The much larger of BR 300-917-megawatt thermal or 325 megawatts of electricity and the slightly larger RITM 255 megawatts of electricity reactors have both been considered as a potential energy source for these floating nuclear power stations. The floating power stations need to be refueled every 3 years while saving up to 200,000 metric tons of coal and 100,000 tons of fuel oil a year. The reactors are supposed to have a lifespan of 40 years. Every 12 years, the whole plant will be towed home and overhauled at the wharf where it was constructed. The manufacturer will arrange for the disposal of the nuclear waste and maintenance is provided by the infrastructure of the Russian nuclear industry. Thus, virtually no radiation traces are expected at the place where the power station produced its energy. Environmental groups are concerned that floating plants will be more vulnerable to accidents and terrorism than land-based stations. They point to a history of naval and nuclear accidents in Russia and the former Soviet Union, including the Chernobyl disaster of 1986. Floating nuclear power stations are planned to be used mainly in the Russian Arctic. Five of these will be used for offshore oil and gas field development and for operations on the Kola and Yamla peninsulas. According to Rosatom, 15 countries, including China, Indonesia, Malaysia, Algeria, Namibia, Cape Verde, and Argentina, have shown interest in hiring such a device.